There is the Parc de Prince, the stadium of the local soccer team, Paris Saint-Germain, but also the Roland Garros stadium for the French Open of tennis every year, every summer, generally at the month of May or June. Yeah. So as we're going to enter now, the other street, you can see the very busy street, that's the Périphérique, the ring road. Now we are entering in the A13, the highway that somebody can get to go up to Normandy. So as we're going to get out of this tunnel, on your left, you're going to see the stadium of Roland Garros, one of the... here on the left, so they make it a little bit bigger, they renovate it. Of the 17th century by the Sun King. So the next exit from the highway is for the palace and the city of Versailles. city today that counts around 100,000 people. C'est parce qu'ils font des travaux en fait. Who was supposed to bring the letter to the lady opened the letter, and the beginning of the letter was "Ma jolie, my beautiful, my beauty, I'm in Mont." So the city has been called Mont la Jolie. Today it's not really a very, very beautiful city, it's a more industrial city. And now they are trying to enlarge this main highway, A13, from Paris to Normandy. It's a very main highway. You see, so a boat is going to be brand new in a few years. A little bit further also, we're going to see an old, well, not so old, electric station of production of electric energy, but closed to that, the year 2017. This one on the right, the station of Porcheville, used for by EDF, which is the electricity company of France. So it has been closed completely for financial reasons. It was very costful. Before that, more than 200 people used to work here. Monet, Normandy, and the right. So Normandy generally was supposed to be the paradise for Impressionism painters. So the first, because many painters also, Impressionist painters were born in Normandy, as for example, a leader called Eugène Houdin. He was born in a small village of Honfleur. It's a small village from where people like Samuel de Champlain left and discovered the Canada and established the city of Quebec. So close to Deauville, Trouville, the very beautiful, elegant cities of Normandy, there is the village of Honfleur, and not far away from the elegant cities of Deauville and Honfleur, there is also the harbor, the port, Le Havre. So Claude Monet was born there. His family was from Normandy. He was very young and he started to work with the painter Eugène Houdin. But was from Honfleur. He was a leader, a professor to the other younger painters. Since he was very, very young, Monet could make beautiful drawings, and so sell all that, very humoristic drawings, and earn his pocket money. But when his family learned that what he wanted to be was a painter, and that he didn't absolutely not continue the family business, they got very, very upset. So they denied him to money, and he decided to live in Algeria for a while with the army in order to earn some money. Then he got typhoid fever, and still his his family didn't want to pay enough money to bring him back. But he had an uncle who was more sensitive to art than his parents. So he paid money to bring Claude Monet back to France. But Monet said that from that trip to Algeria in the North Africa, I got inspired. I had this notion of bright white. And he decided to move to Paris. In Paris, he also passed by Montmartre, and also in Paris, he met, we could say, the woman of his life, at least for a very long time, Miss Camille. Camille was his model, and she became his companion, and they had also a boy together. They had a son. But then, while Monet was in Montmartre in Paris, he couldn't find enough money to buy his colors, to be occupied with paintings. Painting is an expensive occupation. And as we said, his family didn't want to give him money. So he decided, but because his family didn't like also Camille, they didn't approve his relationship with her, they promised him to give him money for colors and painting, but to live from Camille. And unfortunately, he did so, not forever, but still for a while. He moved back to Normandy, and he spent around a year with his family, painting the different landscapes of Normandy. But finally, he decided to go back to his wife and child. He met a very interesting man he became also, in a way, his manager. And so he succeeded little by little to earn some more money. And he decided also to